Welcome back to the show. It is time to talk about what is trending out there. And need we say that we love cat videos?
Yes. If you're just joining us on the program, every time we show a cat on this segment of the show or any segment of any show, we are donating $1 to the BC SPCA.
Where
and we
at?
Will give that to them at the end of the year. We're 461, man. I want to get to a G note before the end of the year, so we got to move it.
I can do that, Mike.
Okay.
Okay. This cat, it's a little 10-week-old kitten. Cats are known to attack if you're not paying attention to them.
Stealth.
So here is Evie. What body part she's starting at,
whoa,
I don't know. Look at the evil. I will get you.
If you die, I'll eat you. Here it goes.
Oh. One more time.
Yeah, one more time.
Yeah,
I like
you
that.
Gotta.
Here we go.
You know what? You know they're gonna attack you, but you just
look
let
at the bum waggle. That's exactly what I do before I attack someone. Okay. Waggle the hiney.
Your poor dear wife.
You know when you? Which way do you throw? Are you right-handed or left-handed?
What am I doing?
Are you right-handed or left-handed?
I'm right-handed in some sports.
So
left
when
in
you're
the other.
Throwing something, what are you?
Right-handed.
Okay,
but
so...
Wow.
You know, what I was going to say is, have you ever noticed how awkward people are when they're throwing with their opposite hands? But no, you're awkward with your proper hand. But there's something beautiful about watching people throwing with their opposite hand, because no matter what you do, it never feels completely right. This video was posted the other day. It's just titled, Men Throwing Rocks with the Other Hand, and it is a beauty.
Tu t'en vas.
I love the music. It's,
I know, the
it's
music
very
is beautiful.
Serene.
Yeah. And if you try this at home, you will realize that this is totally accurate. This is what it feels
hey,
like.
Hey, that's what they're doing.
With your raquette. Because you want to be casual. So what they
hey.
Told these guys, hey, there goes my rock.
Wait, here goes that one.
They
hey.
told them to take a running start and then throw. Because if you just stand there and you throw, that's my favorite.
Or that could happen.
Right there, as you go. This is the last one.
I like the slow motion on the heavyset men.
Well, it's artistic that way. But so if you stand there and you throw, it seems pretty casual. But as soon as you put a couple of steps in it, try it at your office, try it at your house, wherever you are, have a rock throwing contest.
Good backyard game.
Without you go. Now, from that to pure hard science, in 1957, five men decided that they would be part of an experiment to find out what would happen if a nuclear bomb was detonated 10,000 feet directly above them. Yes, that sounds crazy.
Sounds
yes,
smart.
That was crazy. This is the video to prove it. This was posted by NPR the other day, and it's madness. There's the planes. There goes the nuclear device.
Oh, I love their sign.
We felt a heat pulse, a very bright light. A fireball, it is red, the sky looks black about it. It is boiling above us there. It is rapidly, oh. Look, it's covered, there is the ground.
So.
It is over.
Did they do a follow-up, or did any of them live?
I've been trying to find a follow-up to it, and I don't know what
real?
The follow-up is. That is absolutely for real. It was a 2-kiloton MB-1 nuclear air-to-air rocket launch from F-89
seems
Scorpion
brilliant.
Interceptor fighter. You can find it. We will post these links at the bottom of our YouTube page, because it's
Darwinism.
Hey, man, five guys. You found five volunteers to stand under a nuclear device in 1957. It's not like they didn't know what happened.
Wow. The human population. We're going to take a quick break.